Hi, this is Harald from Imminence, and you're listening to Total Rock.
Or of Total Rock, and today I have the honor of being joined by Harald of Imminence, all the way from Sweden. And I'm super excited today because only a couple of hours ago, I've learned that they've announced their brand new album, Heaven in Hiding, that's going to be out November 26th. How are you feeling with all that news around you, Harald? How are you today?
I'm doing perfectly fine. Thank you so much. And thanks for having me on the interview. Well, I mean, the feedback has been incredible, absolutely overwhelming, and just so much more positive than we could ever expect. Of course, we've noticed a significant increase in, the amount of streams, the amount of views and clicks, and, you know, the feedback and the increase in social media followers. And also, you know, since we started to release songs from this album, you know, starting with Temptation, that was released before the summer. So, of course, we saw that, okay, people are actually seeming to enjoy what we're doing lately, which is, of course, very wonderful to see. But the feedback, you know, the response of the actual announcement was absolutely incredible. And I don't know, I don't want to draw too many conclusions, but we actually had a server error on our web shop that happened somewhere around the moment where people started ordering, because, you know, there was a pretty heavy pressure. So I don't want to say it's because of that solemnly, but of course there might be something behind this to say that, okay, there's a lot of people that pre-ordered the album already, you know.
That's great news. And we've been enjoying the sounds over the last couple of weeks. Obviously, Heaven in Hiding is also the title track. So we already have a few teases out of that as well. But I want to touch on kind of what started the band as well. I've listened to a few interviews that you had in the past, and I've even seen on one of your social pages that it touched on following dreams, about how the band is a dream that the members are following. And I wanted to know how you dealt with either holding on to the dreams or maybe even giving up on some other dreams in the past. Obviously, Corona in the last 2 years changed our path and made us either give up on some or work harder for some other dreams. How did you feel over the last couple of years or in general since birth about your challenge, your chase after your dreams?
Yeah.
What helped you follow them?
Well, if we rewind the tape until to the day where the band actually took form, I would say that we started up quite differently than a lot of bands are doing these days, or even, you know, since the past 5 years or whatever. I think because we really started from the rock bottom. Imminence has been a band for quite some time. Like, me and Eddie started the band when we were teenagers, like we were only kids. And I think a lot of musicians and band members, especially in like the alternative scenes, they go to that phase, they play local shows, they're in local garage bands, and they join up with the people from different projects that are actually a bit more driven and really have the talent that it takes. But we really started from the very bottom together, and we went through every little single step, like every step that you can possibly think of. And it wasn't really easy at times. And I think for me, it was so hard to believe that being a band on a somewhat professional level was just, you know, for me, not a very likely scenario. I remember when we were like 18, 19 years old, we talked about, oh man, what if we ever get to do an album, you know, record an album? Can you believe if that would happen? You're like, no, it's never going to happen, you know. Because we the way we started is like a small village somewhere in this very, you know, far south in Sweden, on a village of 4,000 people. We rehearsed in a basement, and there were no scene, you know, there were no local shows. There were some metal bands coming to play, but that was like in a city far away from you. And you couldn't tour in Sweden back in those days, not in this scene, not as a local band. It was just not happening. So we went through all the stages and, you know, learning to write songs and learning to practice together, and, you know, starting out being pretty, pretty bad at what you're doing. You know, you don't know how things work in the beginning, but there's still that drive. And I think the passion for music and the passion of expressing yourself and trying to get something more out of your life than the opportunities that were presented to you, and really trying to go for that no matter what. And also not understanding how far I was or where we were from achieving that dream, And I wouldn't say that I'm living the dream right now, but in a way, you know, I am and we are. But I mean, I would say that the only thing that really kept us going was the fact that we were seeing that it gave so much back. And really, when we started touring and meeting people that somehow in our early days had discovered the band, came to the small little shows that we played and really trying to tell us that, okay, your music really meant a lot for me. And you really made a difference in my life by writing these songs. And that was really something that gave that continuous drive and the need to continue and not really caring about the obstacles and the problems on the way when the reward of doing it and touring and writing music was just so much bigger. And considering Corona here and the COVID pandemic, it's been very tough in a way, because it sort of ruptures your balance. We're used to the cycle when you write music, release it, go on tour, then go back to the same cycle again. And of course you start questioning, okay, will we ever be able to hit the road again? Will live music be back? And, you know, are we going to be at the same level we are at without touring and playing shows? But the feedback that we received from our fans has been so supportive. Like, they've been listening and streaming our music more than ever before. They've, you know, kept our web shop very well going, you know, by still supporting us, buying merch, because we're handling everything ourselves. Like, we're buying it, we're packing it, we're sending it out. And they've really been okay, really, really shown to us that, okay, guys, we're still going to be here for you when all this is over. And hopefully we are seeing the end of it now. Yeah.
And if I'm mistaken, one major challenge within the band is the fact that Eddie and your cat, they don't get along. How is that affecting it? If I'm not mistaken, Eddie doesn't get along with most cats, or most cats don't get along with Eddie. Is there some sort of a happy ending to this entire story? Are they going to be friends? Is the band doing some sort of a Cats musical cover to bring Cats and Eddie together?
Not really, but I would say that he's getting, you know, we have two Sphinx cats, naked cats, which are really cool. And I think the temper is a bit different. Eddie is definitely a dog person, but they're I think in a way, in their social behavior, I would say they're more like dogs in a social way than other cats. So they do get along pretty well.
Okay, I'm happy to hear that.
Yeah.
And I want to confront you with a rumor, especially it got even stronger now that we have news about the album coming out. But some of your fans think that the future of the band is related to how much facial hair Eddie has. So the heavier the music becomes, the more beard Eddie has. So recently, in recent videos, we saw more facial hair. Does it mean that Heaven is in Hiding is going to be a very heavy album compared to previous singles?
I don't want to talk too much on what's coming on the album, but I wouldn't draw that.
That's really mean, by the way.
Yeah, for sure. I can talk about a bit about it, but I don't want to ruin too much of a surprise for you. But I think the last single we put out, which is called Ghost, is one of the most, in a way, heavy tracks. And I don't really see any facial hair on Eddie in that one. So I wouldn't say that that hypothesis is maybe not too valid. But points, yeah, good points for trying. Yeah, absolutely.
So what do we need to know and what can we know about Heaven in Hiding? As we said, it's going to be out November 26th. We already got two or three singles out of it. And there's also a tour around Europe and the UK from the 15th of February. What else is there in the know that we can enjoy?
Well, what I can tell you about Heaven in Hiding is that if you take every album release that we have done as a band, what we did in the starting process is that we started on the previous album that we released, and then you just tore it down to the ground. Like, you broke it down. There was nothing left of it. You know, you start from something new. You don't want to build on something that you already did. And I think that made us discover something new. We reinvented ourselves. We found new ways to create music and new ways to look at our artist persona in a way. And when it comes to Heaven in Hiding, there has not been a single release or collection of songs that better embodies what we are and will always be as Imminence. That's what I can tell you.
That teases us very well. And I want to get more, and I'm going to keep on coming for more singles. And now that I know that you guys are going to be touring around Europe and the UK in February, then the excitement is just boiling inside me. But I want to touch a little bit on the title of the album as a bit of a kind of on the literal use of the word heaven. I was wondering if there is some sort of a spiritual, faithful, maybe even religious theme in the album, or maybe just something that you would like to share about your life and faith.
Of course. From my personal point of view, the album title and what you can see is not related to faith in a religious way. Our lyrical themes and our music is open for interpretation. If you find the meaning or a meaning in our lyrics or in our music that is helpful or has some sort of deeper context or, you know, for you, then it is exactly what that song is about, basically. But when it comes to me, of course, there is always a challenge to sometimes, there is a challenge to keep faith in difficult times. And I think that's something that everybody is struggling with. And where you're finding your answers that motivates you for keeping on going through difficult times and hardships in your life is not always, let me try to phrase this in a good way. I think it's possible for you to access, right, maybe not right in front of you, but I think everybody is able to find that strength, you know, to find that thing that motivates them and keeps them going in their life. And if you find that in religion or in other sort of faith or whatever it can be, then that is the right for you. But this is maybe more what the meaning of the title is about for me personally.
So thank you very much for sharing that. And before we say goodbye, I was just wondering, since I think the last tour that you had before Corona started affecting our music interaction, you had an acoustic album and tour. Is it something that's going to come into either the upcoming release or the upcoming tour?
Well, actually, it was, it was an acoustic EP. It was. And that tour, Live in Concert Halls, which it was called, unfortunately got pushed due to the pandemic. So that's going to occur during April in 2022. So that whole tour just got pushed. And the feedback on the announcement was so incredible, really. So we decided that, of course, we don't want to cancel it and put it on sale for another time, because it seemed like a lot of people were really, you know, excited for it to happen. So we decided to, okay, we move it until next year.
Well, now we have so many things to wait for. As we said, Harald of Imminence, we got Heaven in Hiding coming out November 26th. And you guys are going to be on tour around Europe and the UK from the 15th of February. Is there anything else you want to add to fans and listeners out there before we say goodbye?
Well, we really want to thank everybody that has supported us through the years we've been in the band and that are as excited for the album release as we are. And we really hope to see you on the next tour and really hope that you will enjoy the new album, because we think it's really something special for us.
Harald of Imminence, thank you much for your time and sharing some news about the upcoming future of the band. It's been a pleasure talking to you. Thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you.